Now, Bellary has become a synonym for illegal mining.
It's visible, the pollution is visible. The dust is everywhere, dust is in food, dust is in water, and this is toxic dust. In terms of money, it is the biggest scandal of independent India.
ಮೊದಲು 23 ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಊಟ ಹಾಕ್ತಿದ್ವಿ ಸರ್ ಯಾರನ್ನ ಬರಲು ಅಷ್ಟು ಬೆಳೀತಿದ್ವಿ ಅಂಥ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ನಾವೇ ಜೀವನ ಮಾಡೋದು ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಯ್ತು ಸರ್
ಇವಾಗ ಧೂಳಿ ಪೈಕಿಲೇಸಿ ಗಾಳಿ ನೀರು ಪಾಡಿಜೇಸಿ
ಇಫ್ ಯು ಮೇಕ್ Dracula, the head of a blood bank, you can't expect blood to be conserved. You will have to see blood being drained away. And that's what's happening in Karnataka.
The way this country is looted by these fellows all over, make Ghaznavis and Nadashas look like small-time pickpockets.
Pantalu selu pachani kondalu smuggling palai pojinavi mining mafia vanavampulaku manadesi pojinaji.
This is a mixture of a legacy of feudal attitudes coupled with a kind of crony capitalism.
Lagara haile sa lagara rodu roller mundadu gai sagara.
But the contrast is remarkable. On the one hand, as I said, you could contrast them, their brand of buccaneering corrupt capitalism with the more socially responsible philanthropy oriented capitalism of Narayan Murthy.
As a congressman, if I want to go to Bellary, I am joking that I am getting a visa and I am entering in the Bellary district.
The chief minister, it's like having mounted a tiger which you cannot dismount now.
Moodu vantula neelato nindina samudram ammanu soodandi. భూగర్భంలో బాంబులు పేల్చి బద్దలు కొట్టింది ఎవడన్నా
రెడీమేడ్ అంకల్ రాజశేఖర్ రెడ్డి మిలగయా రెడీమేడ్ మదర్ సుష్మా స్వరాజ్ మిలగయా
కన్న తల్లి తను బాలకు కన్న మేసే దొంగలు
ఇట్ ఈస్ ట్రూలీ ఎ క్రైమ్ స్టోరీ
రోచురాయి మోటార్ల షికార్లకు కుదుపొచ్చిందట
బళ్ళారి ఈజ్ ఎ న్యూ రిపబ్లిక్
భూగోళం మరి పండి పిండి మసి అయి మసి అయిపోతుంది
ఇవ భూమి ఎల్ల ఒడదు బిటారల్రీ ఎల్ల తిందాకి బిటారన్న చేల మీద తుమ్ము జల్లి పైరు పంట పాతరేసి.
It's a rape of democracy in some sense.
Lagara hai lissa lagara, rodu rolaru mundadu gai sagara.
Ond gudi edaku kuda ingilla.
Ganulante nela talli daachina kanijalu, mudivesina moota vippi manaki icche varalu.
Underhand illegals, sometimes violent tactics they've used to build their empire.
Who strategizes, who's extremely sharp, who's very shrewd.
He almost shrugged off his wealth. He was very nonchalant about it.
The mining lobby is funding political parties overtly.
Camera.
They are the monarchs and they are the kings.
From the beginning, I used to tell that I am very honest, I am correct, I have not done any mistake, and this is purely political.
Originally from Bellary. Bellary is Harpanalli, my place is considered as part of Bellary. It is only in 1950s that it was discovered that it reached deposits of iron ore. People used to call it Kabna Kallo, Kabna Bangara. Kabna is iron, Bangara is gold.
What I saw was it was 12 degrees partially populated, arid and semi-arid in some parts, with some 180 square kilometers of hills sandwiched in all these open spaces. This is the only area where there is to be high precipitation of rainfall. We had good forests, had excellent flora and fauna. We used to have tigers, used to have panthers, used to have bear, sloth bear. Very rich in wildlife.
I spent my childhood in Hospet, Bellary district. When my father was a mining engineer, he was working for one of the state government companies, which was involved in extraction and supply of iron ore to the public sector undertakings in Karnataka. Then there was no scope for exports. Hospet was a very small town. It was one of the best towns to live in at that point of time. And the mining areas resembled a portion of the Western Ghats, with greenery, a lot of mist, clouds. And it was unimaginable for anybody to think that this kind of a location could be a part of North Karnataka.
Difference has come because till 2003-2004, the fines, which come to nearly 70% of the total production, had no market. And then before the Beijing Olympics, China went after the infrastructure in a big way. The requirement of steel went up, accordingly the requirement of iron ore went up. And when this boom came, China was prepared to take the fines. And that's how the fines started moving from 2004, you can say.
I told very clearly, this is from the beginning, my stand is very clear that I am not for export. Just even export, it should be banned, and we should encourage every mine owner for value-added projects only. So with our mining policy only, with our Karnataka state government also, we have taken a very strongly, and we have introduced this mining policy only for value-added addition.
Well, you know, illegal mining, there are three types. In fact, sometimes mining without lease, secondly, encroachment, thirdly, technically illegal, not renewal of mining lease, all these things. But even second one, that Bellary by encroachment, that is very rampant there in the Bellary. We have got about 103 mines there. Out of that, 95 are on iron ores. Out of 95 iron ores, two are sub judice, 93. But at that time, when throughout the country, and there was so much noise about this illegal mining. We gave the responsibility of inspecting the mines to IBM. So IBM inspected all the 93 mines of iron ore. Out of that, 89 mines were found that there is illegal mining. And 30 mines were suspended. Operation was suspended by IBM. So you can just see the gravity of the situation, and particularly in the Bellary hospital region.
గాలి మోటార్ ఎక్కేసి
దేర్ యూస్ టు బి ఎ లికర్ లాబీ విచ్ సపోర్టెడ్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ ఎవ్రీ గవర్నమెంట్ అండ్ దట్ వాస్ డన్ ఇన్ ఎన్ ఆనరబుల్ సార్ట్ ఆఫ్ వే వీ ఆల్ అండర్స్టూడ్ ఇట్ అండ్ దెన్ దెర్ వాజ్ ఎన్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ లాబీ ఇన్ కర్ణాటక విచ్ వాజ్ మోర్ సాత్విక్ దాన్ ది అదర్ బికాస్ సమ్ బెనిఫిట్ కేమ్ టు ది పీపుల్ నౌ దేర్ ఇస్ ఎ మైనింగ్ లాబీ అండ్ ఇట్స్ ఎ క్రిమినల్ లాబీ
కళ్ళ ముందు అన్యాయం కాలు దువ్వుతున్నదన్నా.
యు డోంట్ నో వాట్ దే రిమూవ్, యు డోంట్ నో వాట్ దే సెల్, యు డోంట్ నో హౌ మచ్ దే మనీ దే
మేడ్.
జనార్దన్ రెడ్డి ఈజ్ వెరీ బ్రెయిని, ఆల్సో ఈస్ నాట్ రెడ్ మచ్.
That you get a license, lease to mine in a place somewhere in the district of Bellary, and that license is used as if it is James Bond's license to kill.
The name's Bond. James Bond.
ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಕುಟುಂಬದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾಡಿರುವಂಥ ಆರೋಪಗಳಿಗೆ ವಿತ್ ಡಾಕ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕನ್ನೋದಂಥ ಒಂದು ವಿಷಯ ಮತ್ತು ನಾನು ಒಂದೇ ಮಾತನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿದೆ, ದೇವರು ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಏನು ಯಾವ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಂತ ಏನು ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅದೆಲ್ಲವೂ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ.
ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮನಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಬಿಗ್ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಕ್ಯಾಂಡಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸೀಡ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಅದರ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ expropriation or exploitation that took place either in the British Raj or prior to that with the East India Company. The reason is this, that here is a commodity which is owned by the people of the country under the constitution, whose cost of mining is a mere 10% of its final price, and it is available in large quantities on the surface. That is why the cost of mining is very low. Being given to the private sector for a paltry royalty of 1.5%.
The more the money power and the more political prominence they got, they felt that they could do everything, you know, anything and everything. And that's why the rocks or the markers dividing Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh, they have not been destroyed actually. They have a life of their own. You know, when the Andhra people come to survey, they come into the right place. And then they want to mine, then the rocks move on to this side. So when the Karnataka people go to survey, the rocks find a life of their own and they move on to the other side. That's the Reddy Samrajya or the fiefdom or whatever. So they just go on mining there. So they haven't destroyed this one. They just play with the state boundaries.
Yare yene andru kuda nanage onde ond piece of evidence ಒಂದು ಪೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎವಿಡೆನ್ಸನ್ನು ತಾವು ತೋರಿಸಿದರೆ ಯಾವ ಎಂಕ್ವೈರಿಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಬೇಡ. ನಾನು ಇದೇ ರೀತಿ ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಫರೆನ್ಸನ್ನು ಕರೆದು ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಸಮ್ಮುಖದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ರಾಜೀನಾಮೆ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು
ಸಿದ್ಧರಾಗಿದ್ದೇನೆ.
They funded the BJP MLAs and they are the instrument to bring the BJP government in power.
They functioned independently.
They are in the practice. Because we have come into the power only after 2008. After 2008 assembly elections only we came into the power. So up to 2008 they were in that practice with all this illegal money and with scam money. They are the scam kings and illegal kings, and they are for all bad things they are the kings.
They are the monarchs and they are the kings.
I was discussing this with a senior BJP leader, and he came up with a wonderful analogy to explain this. He said, in an Indian family, when one son gets married to a girl from the same community, and another son goes and gets married outside the community, the family accepts both because you need the business of the family to go on. But the second daughter-in-law is always a little different. But because she may have brought a lot of money with her, she is still important. But then she is never accepted by the group. And a lot of them feel that if you talk to the people who have been part of the BJP since the birth of the party, they would argue that this is something stifling for them. But they also would agree that this is something which we have brought upon ourselves in our desire to come to power, and this is something we need to therefore deal with.
And the alliance between Rajshekhar Reddy family and Gali brothers was simply unable to do anything. As such, even the high command is not against this kind of money making, because that helps their party, and also they will have a trusted leader in a particular state. Janardhan Reddy brothers in Karnataka and YSR family in Andhra Pradesh, if they fall in line, they would not mind whatever they do. And even BJP party, if Gali brothers fall in line and accept Yeddyurappa, make their own money, BJP would not have any problem. And they had no problem actually till a particular point. Only when Gali brothers were having their own ambitions, extra ambitions of controlling the entire state, crossing the line, then BJP had a problem.
If we look at two or three factors behind the transformation of Indian politics and also the politics in the state for the last two decades or three decades, we find that more and more businessmen who amass wealth through means which are fair or which are dubious, they seek to enter the portals of the legislatures. And if you look at the social background of legislators in the state, though they claim that they are agriculturists, but actually they are most of them are businessmen. Most of the MPs, most of the MLAs, large number of MLAs, large number of MPs are leading businessmen of the state. So that's one reason. The second reason probably you may have to, if you are thinking about the kind of mining, you know, lobby or leaders who are emerging from these fields, you may have to look at the background of Rayalaseema region. Rayalaseema region has historically strong leaders who care very little about law.
The kind of result that emerged after the 2008, May 2008 elections, there was a hung assembly and the BJP was in requirement of numbers. And the Reddys again came into play, they used their money power, so to say, to...